Yaakov Avinu's request was fulfilled in this coming parsha, Parshas Korach. The parsha starts by saying, "Vayikach Korach ben Yitzhar ben Kehas ben Levi," but the name of his great grandfather was not mentioned. It doesn't say Levi ben Yaakov, and that's following the request of Yaakov Avinu in Parshas Vayechi, in Bereishis Perek Mem Tes. When Yaakov Avinu speaks to Shimon ve'Levi, he says, "Besoidam al tavoy nafshi, b'kehalam al teichad kevoidi." As Chazal say, and Rashi mentioned, "Besoidam al tavoy nafshi" means, "Don't mention my name when it has to do with Ma'ase Zimri ben Salu, Nesi beis Av Lashim Oini, b'kehalam al teichad kevoidi." Do not mention my name when it has to do with Vayikach Korach ben Yitzhar ben Kehas ben Levi. And that's exactly what happens in this week's parsha. What's the reason for that? The pasuk says in Bereishis, "Ki, because." "Ki be'apam argu ish uvirtzoinam ikru shoy." Means the following. They did Ma'ase Shechem following their anger, and that's what their plan about Mechiras Yosef as well. And Yaakov Avinu says, like Michoira, it's not to do with him. There is a pshat that I have heard from my Rebbein, that the reason for Yaakov Avinu's request is because when Shimon ve'Levi came up with those two actions, with the Ma'ase Shechem to kill the entire city after the story about Dinah, their sister, and when they were involved with Mechiras Yosef, they said that in both cases, the reason for their action was very much dedicated to Shlichus L'Shem Shamayim. With Ma'ase Shechem, they are canine. They are sensitive to tznius. And that's made them to kill the entire city. With Mechiras Yosef, they are sensitive to brotherhood. And that's made them to sell Yosef. If all what motivates them is about Yirat Shamayim, says Yaakov Avinu, we would never have any other incidents that are contradicting their motivation. Since Korach was involved with Machlokes, and he is a descendant of Levi, and since Zimri ben Salu, a descendant of Shimon, is involved with lack of tznius, Yaakov Avinu says, no way that all the way back in Sefer Bereishis, you would say that what motivated you was kanaus, sensitivity, responsibility to tznius and to brotherhood. Because we learn from here a big lesson. When we do different actions, we are investing in our children's and generations to come. If a person really is doing L'Shem Shamayim, we'll never have an incident that comes later in history that contradicts it. So says Yaakov Avinu, "Besoidam al tavoy nafshi, b'kehalam al tichad kevodi," because ki, it's found later in history, "ki be'apam argu ish uvirtzonam ikru shoyer," as Rashi explains, shoyer is keneged Yosef. The Gemara says in Baba Kama, a story about Nechunya choifer shichi, that did and prepared pits for the people who came to Yerushalayim for the regalim, for the yamim tovim, for the holidays. And his daughter was saved, even though she fell into the pit. And the Gemara says, "Bedavar sheitztaer bo isoy tzadik, lo yikashel bo izaron." The same here. If what would motivate Shimon ve'Levi would be tznius and brotherhood, we'll never have later in history Korach and Zimri. As I said, it's a big lesson for all of us to try to invest into our actions, to make sure and to try to make sure that our children and grandchildren are following the Derech HaTorah VeHayinah. Good Shabbat.